A very warm welcome to all of you. Hi, I'm Prachi. The absolute core of my conversation with you today will be basis my experience in the past 1 year, specifically over the past 2 decades of my experience. And I say so primarily because the past one year specifically as a community to all of us has given a very different view to what we were doing earlier. I mean, all of us were forward-looking people. All of us were forward-looking, numbers-looking, business professional. What we have realized in the past 1 year is everything is so fluid from a business perspective. The things that you want to do, like the plan, do, check, act of creating the business, of running a fourth entire campaign, of running forth your entire domain, that really does not work anymore. Every day is a new challenge. Every day is a new discovery. Let me put forth my thoughts very candidly, what we have seen specifically in the past 13, 14 months of this entire situation. And I don't say COVID situation as a negative situation or a positive situation. It's a phase, it's going to pass. I may think people and the businesses who will hold forth are the ones who have a very forward-looking approach. Now, what do I mean by when I say forward-looking approach? What is it that has actually truly brought forth an organization's soul forward during these times? Well, from a brand perspective, since I work on brands very categorically and people think that it's the glamorous side of the most glamorous domain of the business. Well, I don't disagree. It is definitely the most glamorous part of it. What has been the primary change which I have seen? I have seen one thing for sure is the roles becoming far more transient. I mean, holding on to a domain, saying that I'm a salesperson, I'm a marketer, I'm a IT person, I'm a operations person, does not hold true anymore. Businesses are no more unidirectional. A marketing plan is no more unidirectional. People who have actually stepped out of their comfort zone, and not only from a perspective of learning new things, it is from a perspective of learning new things to make an impact. Knowing exactly that what I'm doing today might not have an impact 5 months down the line, forget about 5 months, 5 days down the line might not have an impact, and being ready to face that change. Let's take an example of what we have been having as a conversation since the past 5 years. This has been an active conversation of the role of a CMO, a CDO, CTO, and a CIO, that sooner or later it's going to merge, and very soon marketers will be out of job. I mean, I would not like that to happen for sure. But is it true that these roles are merging and these roles are no more unidirectional? Absolutely it is. A marketer is no more a marketer. A marketer is a person who understands how to reach a consumer. At the end of the day, every person who is associated with a brand should know exactly how to reach their end consumer and to make that click or that buy or that purchase. If it is a marketer, if it is the tech guy, if it is the IT guy, if it is the operation guy, just doesn't matter. Just doesn't matter till the person knows the entire consumer cycle journey and is actually ready to invest on his or her brand. Let's take an example of how I see the role of a CDO or a CMO or a CIO or a CTO merge very fast. I mean, unless a marketer really knows very nitty-gritties of how to reach the N is equal to one customer voice or the mind, it's never going to be a successful click, as I said. It's never going to be a successful consumer journey to the buying or the after sale or the top end of the funnel, bottom end of the funnel, which is the loyalty part of it. You're never going to reach there. Unless and until you understand how you are going to reach that, unless and until you are going to understand the analytics part of it. So the marketer's job is not to create only beautiful campaigns. It is going to be making sure that the sale happens and the final advocacy and the loyalty thing happens. Same goes for an IT person or a CIO or a CTO for that matter. At this point of time, most of the businesses are seeing such a mammoth change in their entire spine, the backbone of a business is no more the same. Look at how retail is changing. Look at how pharma industry is changing. Look at how FMCG are doing businesses, speaking about consumers. So at the end of the day, if the tech guy is not the one who's going to create the entire framework of a changed business, how is the mantle being run by the sales or the operations or the marketing person? So there is a lot more business perspective to every person who's involved in the brand. I don't say business only from a perspective of number. I say in creating the brand is going to happen. And it's going to be far more evident. Let's also go back a step before. I always say this before marketers, all of us are consumers. I mean, we would like to be treated in a certain way by the brands that we interact with. So let's go back a step. When we say as a consumer, what am I looking for from a brand? I'm definitely looking for two things. I'm looking for to a sensitivity. I'm looking for to a humanized brand. Let's take an example of the pharma industry at this point in time. I mean, 5 years before down the line, the pharma industries will not be, pharma companies will not be only acting as a solution to people who are seeking solution when they're sick. Pharma companies will actually interact with you at a consumer level. People who they would like to sell their products before you actually get sick and interact with the brand. And that means that that's exactly how footprints are created, brand footprints are created. And that's exactly how most of us are going to build our brand. So it's not going to be the job of an FMCG company to create that heart tug and be able to create a human brand. It's the job of that company who's going to produce a vaccine also. Let's look at the roles that people have been working on. And also let's look at how people are going to interact and in creating a brand. Think about all of us. We are all logging in from remote locations. Some of us actually have joined new companies and aren't even aware of the surroundings we'll be working on or the people we work with. I think our induction would have shown us a face or two, but apparently that's about it. So let's look at how people create magic also when they go and create brands which create magic at the end of the day. So there are a group of five people. Say, for example, look at a startup, how a startup is created. There are a group of five people all logging in from different locations, all having that one single mission of A, creating a brand which means something to them, creating a brand which means something to the consumer. Also, being able to connect or create a common soul amongst all the five people to be able to create the brand. People logging in from various locations, people trying to hold each other in creating the brand and the story, which bring forth to any kind of sales or numbers as every business talks about, that's going to be very, very important. And it's not going to change. I mean, COVID is not going to go away tomorrow when all of us get vaccinated. This situation of a balance of work from home and remote location or from offices is going to come to a phase wherein all of us will definitely are going to find a balance. So how is it important for organizations to go forth and create the same kind of magic when you had, 1,500 people coming in together and creating that kind of noise saying that, okay, this is the brand we're trying to build. How do you create that kind of magic? This is the time when I've seen organizations step up and hold hands of experienced business people saying that we're not letting go of experienced business people. We are going to train them to do the business in a completely new avatar. And we're going to get them geared up to leapfrog to the next level so that we leapfrog as an organization rather than just finding new solutions. Of course, there are new entrants. Of course, there are new people who are coming into the system to strengthen the entire spine of the organization. But what has happened to organizations who have actually held together people and used the experience of people and then made the changes with them, along with them, those are the ones who have moved forward. So when I say the business are going to be dynamic and the roles are not going to stay in black and white anymore, what I mean is the ones that are going, the what people who are going to stay successful and the organizations who are going to go the longer way are the ones who don't see any situation or any challenge as a continuing or enduring work and are ready to change themselves more so than ever at this point of time. Every role is definitely going to be transient. Every role will go, is going to merge into each other. And the ones that are going to stay true to the gray part of the business are the ones who are going to succeed. Thank you.